Geneticist Diana van Heemst has the answer.
I guess, you know, in a lot of species, if you look at dogs, horses, elephants, it's actually the smaller variants of that species that seem to live longer. And of course, then the real question is, does it also apply to humans?
Well, that's not so easy to answer. There are so many factors that influence human lifespans that it's hard to tell what's down to size and what's down to, say, diet or exercise. To get to the bottom of this, Diana has been re-examining a remarkable 1970s study, which homed in on a group of people with very similar lifestyles, but varying heights. Professional athletes.
For example, American baseball players, there's a nice encyclopedia, which is actually a rich source of information, not only for the baseball fans about, you know, all the details about the performances and nicknames, but also actually it contains date of birth, date of death, the adult height and their weight.
If you know their height and age of death, you can start looking for a pattern.
Wally Burnett, 1.83 meters. Murray Dixon, 1.78 meters.
The original study used data from hundreds of players, but we can see what they discovered by looking at just a few.
I took from the Encyclopedia of Baseball 9 representative examples of baseball players. And we have, you know, attached them to the ball based on the height and the age at that. And this kindly mimics the original study, which made use of the full sample of the encyclopedia, which found this negative correlation between height and the age at that.
The 1970s study found that size did matter. Being 5 centimeters shorter meant, on average, you would live for 2 years longer. The big question is why? And it's only now, 4 decades later, that researchers like Diana van Heemst have come up with a plausible explanation.
In order to grow, our body makes growth hormone, which, you know, stimulates growth. But at the same time, it also influences lots of other processes in our body. And if we look at the data that have been derived from work on other animals, we can see that those growth hormones, they stimulate the body to grow. And this is kind of a signal that there's enough food, that, you know, there's favorable conditions, that it would be wise to invest as much as possible energy in growth and reproduction. And this may come at a cost, because it means there's less energy available to invest simply in maintaining our bodies in good shape. And actually, when conditions get adverse or become less favorable, like when there is a food shortage or lots of toxins, then as a consequence or as a response to that, we don't grow, we kind of stop growth, and we really invest the available energy in maintaining our body and trying to kind of, you know, survive this period of hardship until things get better.
It seems like being big comes at a big price. But for tall people, there is some light at the end of the tunnel.
However, size is not the only thing that matters. There's lots of things that people can do themselves to adopt a healthy lifestyle, like, you know, not smoking, healthy food, lots of exercise. So it matters, but it's not the only thing that matters.